On the program this evening, we're going to introduce you to McCoy Tyner, a great jazz pianist. Jan will tell us about tree reading and numerology. We'll find out how to cook a cheap meal, and we'll take a walk around Vaillancourt.
And this evening, we're high above North Beach at Point. I can't do this.
I used to be a happy TV news.
You guys, don't laugh now. I can't see Steve, but I can see you guys.
It's impossible, Jan. We could not have changed that much in 3 years.
Well, we were younger back then.
Yeah, and I at least was thinner. You really haven't changed.
And hopefully we've improved at least that much.
Yeah, at least. Perhaps this is a good time to share with everybody some of our more memorable evening experiences.
You lived here in New York.
For 18 years, you said.
18 years I've been here. Yeah.
So why New York, Leroy? Of all the places you could live
in the
world.
You're here, that's no question. You're here, you see it. It's...
Our trip to New York with Leroy Neiman and the tough assignments, La Costa, a super spa for the rich.
Yeah. Tristan, Tristan, everybody's feeling great. They're twisting, twisting, they're twisting the night away.
I'll never forget the day we flew into Wiseman, a tiny village 60 miles north of the Arctic Circle.
Well, the wind's blowing at about 5 miles an hour, and it's 0 degrees as I stand here outside the main terminal of Wiseman International Airport. Now, we assume this is the main terminal because it's the only building at this airport. And it has occurred to several of us on the crew here that at this moment, Jan and Bert Arnowitz and the rest of his crew are on the beach in Carmel, photographing people building sand castles. We'll get you for this.
Well, as we said, those were evening adventures from the past.
And now let's take a look at what we've got coming up for you in the future.
Maybe there's something contagious about the adventurous spirit of the stuntmen, or maybe it's just that some people, by nature, are willing to risk personal safety for the sake of an extraordinary special effect. But whatever the reason, two members of our crew, Steve Kotton and Paul Collardo, decided to try and capture a spectacular car flip from what they thought was a very close but safe angle. They were wrong. And as you can see in this film, taken by an amateur photographer, only a last-minute lunge took them away from the exact spot where the speeding car crashed.
Well, those are some of the adventures we're going to take you to in our fourth season. Right now, we're going to take a short break, a commercial break.
When we come back, a totally different kind of Evening Magazine travel experience, one that's quite, shall we say, uplifting. Stay with us.
Now, a couple years ago, Steve got to go up in a hot air balloon by himself. I tracked him on the ground. This time, we both get to go up.
And this is your first trip, right?
Number one.
I think we're all going to enjoy this.
We're up and away.
Gee, Toto, this doesn't look like Kansas. You know, over the course of the years, we've found that the stories that you all tend to enjoy the most seem to be ones where all of us get to experience an exotic new place.
And one of the places we're going to take you in this new season is to one of America's most fabled mansions. And more in Evening's fourth year, but now it's back to the present in our balloon high above the vineyards.
floating down now onto the grounds, it looks like, of Domaine Chandon, a winery in the Napa Valley. Captain Steve Frattini of Adventures Aloft is going to put us down here, we hope.
And when we get down there, I understand, Steve, there's a bunch of people down there waiting for us to help us celebrate our fourth season on the air.
Well, let's hope the approach works. Successful.
Very, very good.
All right, now how are you going to get out of this gondola with that skirt on to get to the party? The only way to do it is to go to a commercial break. Stay with us. We'll be right back. We are right now at Domaine Chandon at a small but promising little party featuring some of the people who just took us up in those balloons, plus evening show staff members and their close personal friends, I think we'll say.
You know, one of the things that Steve and I both enjoy in doing a show like this, and I know we both agree on it, is that we get to meet such incredible people.
The people who are the subjects of our stories, plus people you just meet out on location shooting the show.
We've met some really interesting people in the past, and we've got some great ones coming up.
Loves you.
This break.
As some of you may have heard or read, I'm going to be leaving the show sometime in the next month or so. Go down to Los Angeles and try my hand as a network news correspondent for a while.
Well, we're going to miss you, Steve. We wish you the world of luck, and I know that you're making this move to seek fame and fortune in smoggy Los Angeles.
Yeah, if not good health. Actually, what I'm doing it for, you know, as you know, is the change and the need for a new challenge and all those reasons which compel you to give up something you love a lot. But at any rate, at times of change like this, I can't help but think back to the very beginning of this show when we made all of those mistakes. And there's one particular sequence from the beginning of the show which I don't think I'll ever forget.
I won't either. Good evening. I'm Jan Yanehiro, and this is Steve Smith.
What do you know that I don't?
Good evening. I'm Jan Yanehiro.
I'll get a name tag.
Oh, never forget that. Neither will you. But I've been practicing, Steve. You know, I've had 3 years of practice, and I've been practicing 5 nights a week, and I finally got it. Steve Fox.
Very good, Jan. But as you know, you got a new name to learn now. And perhaps this is a good time to introduce everybody to Richard Hart.
Now, what's your name?
I think I'm in trouble. My name has 25% more to remember than his. There's one more letter.
That's right.
But it's Hart, H-A-R-T. And if you forget it, just put your hand on your heart.
Oh, right. I'll remember
there
that.
There you go, a little symbolism.
Now, perhaps Richard's voice is familiar to a lot of you because for the last 3 years, Richard has been the morning news anchor in KCBS News Radio. And I tell you, I listen to you. You woke me up in the morning.
I know, you've told me that. But you have to realize that no matter what time you listen to me in the morning, I had already been up and had to go to work. And I'm looking forward to being able to just get up at 11 o'clock like you two.
Uh-huh. Yeah, majorly, sure.
The adventure, the glamour, the
now,
good
now,
food,
wait a second. All right.
That's what you thought, right?
That's until this weekend, yeah.
Last week, we took Richard on his first road trip up to Mendocino with us.
We were shooting a week's worth of programs on a canoe floating down the big river. We were out on the river for 9 hours, and it rained. 8 of those 9 hours. And here's a bit of what it looked like at the very end of the day, Richard's first road trip.
It's just in now. My future co-host is that black lump there. See that black shiny lump? Like Richard! Richard Hart, my new co-host. No, he's coming up!
He's coming up!
Would you like to buy the print? Now, Richard, are you sure you're ready for this?
It rained a whole week that one day, I think.
The dishpan body all
Well, the mosquitoes were glamorous. I'll think of it as an adventure, actually. Well. No, seriously, I'm looking forward to the opportunity to continue doing things like that.
Don't believe it for a moment, but I will drink to the new season.
I will.
Cheers.
Onward and upward. The evening's fourth season, and perhaps now's the time to have at the cake.
I'm ready.
Wow.
I think it's chocolate.
Well, the cake looks terrific, and we have the man here to thank for it.
That's right. This is Gunther Schwarr. He's a pastry chef here. He's a man responsible for this beautiful cake. Now, one big question. What flavor is this cake?
It's chocolate.
Logically enough. Man knows his audience. Well, it looks great. Richard, you have a toast for us here before we begin?
Actually, Jan, they had told me about you and chocolate. But we won't need this with this great cake here.
But that's okay. You can put that aside for another day.
Till next year's anniversary, too. Okay. And I'd like to offer a toast at this time to Steve, that he returns to the Bay Area that he loves so much, I know. Oh, that Jan never runs out of chocolate. And that I get the whole cake to myself.
And to another successful new season for Evening Magazine.
There you go.
Join us this season,
Cheers.
Everybody. Cheers. Well, this looks great. What's happening?